kaya ngan kororiki ngan kobodok karukum bakia inining. So hi everyone, my name is Ricky and today we're going to be talking about the wetlands and how these wetlands have been used for thousands of years by Noongar people. So a lot of the Perth area, surrounding suburbs and even Perth city itself all used to be wetlands, a series of different waterways like rivers, small streams, lakes and waterholes, and these were all very regularly visited by Noongar people. That's because these waterways had a lot of really important resources that you could get from them. All of this knowledge was dependent on the seasons as well. So you had to have a lot of knowledge of the six Noongar seasons. You had to know what time of year it was and what was available during that time of year as well. So during one time of the year, you could be going to the water and you could be collecting some duck eggs or maybe even collecting the duck itself. During other times of the year, you might be going to the water to fish, to get some crayfish or to set up some traps. So the water was used as a way of learning. It was almost kind of like bush school. Throughout the six seasons, Noongar kids would be learning from these different areas and figuring out how you get your food, how you get your different resources, and how to use the land and the waterways. So we may not have access to a lot of these traditional areas anymore, but there are still a lot of beautiful wetlands and waterways around the Perth area that we do have access to. And a lot of this Noongar knowledge, it's still around and it's still really, really important. So the respect and the care of the wetlands is still very much maintained by Noongar people and also a lot of the people that live in Perth as well. So I'm going to leave you with three questions today that I'd like you to research together as a class and come up with some answers that you can actually send back to us at Kings Park Education's email, and we're really looking forward to your answers. So, question number one. There is a suburb in Perth called Belia. I'd like you to find out what Belia actually means in the Noongar language. So the second question is about the waterways, and traditionally we know you can get a lot of different things from the waterways, but Noongars would never actually camp right next to the rivers, the lakes or the waterholes. You would actually camp just a couple hundred metres away. So I want you to all have a think and have a discussion. Why do you think you wouldn't or shouldn't camp right next to these water resources? Why wouldn't you do that? And the third question for everyone to have a think about and a discussion, what can we all do together to make sure that our waterways and our wetlands, they stay beautiful and healthy for us and for future generations? So thank you very much. Looking forward to hearing the answers to these questions, and Borawan Nonak Jenny.